Hi guys, it's me again, and it's another serious topic again. So first of all, I want to show you some notebooks that I bought today. They have like female comic book characters on the covers, and they're very pop artsy, and both of them are made in Zagreb. Okay, so moving on to the more serious topic. I want to talk about company culture and its strategy from my own experience. So I even made some notes in this another lovely notebook. It has lots of cups on it that you can color. I don't know, I hope you can see. Okay, anyway, moving on. So basically, what is culture? Culture is that thing that all that stuff that glues an organization and that is hard to define. This is not really my own definition. I found it in an article in Harvard Business Review. I will link the article below. Okay, so one really important thing for me is hierarchy. I do believe in hierarchy that is flat. I don't believe in having a manager over a manager over a manager over a manager, so you never know who is making decisions, who is really hiring people, and who is really firing them, and you never really know who's responsible. So first of all, I believe in equality, which means that I believe that we all need respect as human beings. So if you're hired to get some part of some work done in a company, that means that company needs you and for that job. So whether you're a junior or a senior, you're not there to be humiliated and for someone to take off their, I'm not only going to say frustrations. People always say frustrations, oh, that's a frustrated person. What does that mean? That's just somehow all of the really bad actions are named one name, are given the one name that slowly starting not to mean so much because everyone's frustrated, right? So along with hierarchy goes trust and interpersonal relationships. People do not believe each other, and if people are incapable of having professional and I don't know how to say that, but relationship, they don't need to be that pleasant, but they have not to be unpleasant, if you know what I mean. If someone is driving on making other people intimidated, if someone is just seriously passive-aggressive, if someone is, yeah, that's what they say, emotional vampire, but, you know, that's just causing unnecessary stress to other workers. So you are there, mainly. You have to be able to focus on what's your job. When you get in the office, or presumably you're working in an office, you need to be able to concentrate on the work. That's what matters the most. If you can't work, if everyone else is trying to distract you, then it's pointless. Your presence there is pointless. It's really such torture. Another thing is people who, some people just talk too much, and you're not there to talk. You're some people, sometimes they will expect you to talk. If you're not much of a talker, if you're more of an introvert person, if you you know, like to keep yourself for yourself, they might consider you unfriendly or unable to fit in or things like that. But I don't think you should give in to that pressure, because if you it's better not to talk too much and not to engage, because those talks lead to another forms of emotional engagement. So people will try to pick up on your maybe insecurities, maybe of you not being prepared for relationships like that, and they will try to get you in something in order to manipulate you. And some people are just sick like that. I'm sorry, but you don't need that. You don't need to be manipulated by your weird, sick colleagues. You need to stick to your work again. If the culture of the company is healthy, you probably wouldn't have to think about these things. You probably wouldn't have to worry, because people will already manage themselves. Some managers think they need to be managers. Some managers are there just to be above other people. Some managers are there. So if someone does not know how to manage other people, then they are not for that position. And it happened to me to be managed with someone who really doesn't care, who lets people get into fights, heck, who gets people talk too much, who gets people to have people to work in an office who don't talk to each other, which is really, really super weird. Some people are acting very selfishly and spreading stress. Those are probably the people that are talking too much. Although there could be someone who's doing that in a more passive-aggressive way, but more noticeable, and definitely behavior that has a lot more impact to other workers is just being so loud about your own problems and expecting to be, being very loud about your own problems, because everyone else has their problems as well. Even if someone doesn't have problems, and that at that point in their lives, they have all a right to enjoy that moment of happiness in their own lives. So they don't need to empathize with their co-worker. They don't need to suffer with them, together with them. And all of that, all that stress spreading thing definitely has impact on productivity. Also, something, this is some really serious topic in Serbia. People do not understand how much silence is important for mental work. And in general, to feel rested. Because people think, and that's why I had so much problems to explain that to my coworkers, to explain that to some ex-roommates, that silence is so much important, and that noise, we studied that in elementary school, that noise is sort of pollution, but people just overlook that. Yes, if you're gathered around the same goal, your boss is probably going to expect you to put all of your tears, sweat, and blood in that goal. Your boss is probably going to expect you to put all of your tears, sweat, and blood in that one goal. But of course, you won't be able to do that if you have to go home after work and worry again how are you going to create additional sources of income because you're underpaid or not paid at that work. So you, or if you're having some other sort of stress. So no one can expect you to work if they're not trying to pay you, to do some quality job and to act the same way as if they would act given the task if they're not paying you. But that's not if the organization doesn't have money and doesn't create any income, then chances are they're not going to have the money to pay you. But of course not everything is in the money. You need to feel the pleasure in the environment with your colleagues, in the working atmosphere and from the work that you're doing. So basically that's that. I don't know, maybe you have anything to add, please do. Okay, so another thing that I've noticed is that many of my viewers are speakers of Serbian or Serbo-Croatian language. So if you think that these videos should be made in Serbian, let me know. Otherwise, I would keep them in English at least for a while. So this was it for this video. Thanks for watching and I hope it wasn't too boring. See you some other time. Bye!